Celebration today. In this Mass, Thomas Amis is grateful to God for his family. He's praying for Sister Veronica Bisieri that God may guide her in her call of sisterhood and grant her a long life. Michael Moyne is grateful to God for a successful burial of his cousin Pendo. May God grant Pendo eternal rest. Holy Cross Mina Ministries Kenya is thankful to God for successful outreaches in Murang'a, Nyahururu, and Juja. We are praying for the families that we minister to that God, that they may continue serving God and doing His will. We are also asking for God's guidance for the work ahead of us, especially in this week. In these intentions, I also add, I pray for my mom who is not feeling well, that through this Mass, God may grant her good health and restore her to strengthen her body, and that the medicine that she will be treated with may help her heal. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God.
And to you, my brothers and sisters. That I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who have been pleased to increase your adopted children in all the world, and who made the blood of the martyrs Saint Andrew King Tae-gon and his companions the most fruitful seed of Christians, grant that we may be defended by their help and profit always from their example. Bless us in our needs today, and heal my mom who is not well. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the book of Proverbs. The king's heart is a stream of water in the hand of the Lord. He turns it wherever he will. Every way of a man is right in his own eyes, but the Lord weighs the heart. To do righteousness and justice is more acceptable to the Lord than sacrifice. Haughty eyes and a proud heart, the lamp of the wicked, are sin. The plans of the diligent lead surely to abundance, but everyone who is hasty comes only to want. The getting of treasures by a lying tongue is a fleeing vapor and a snare of death. The soul of the wicked desires evils. His neighbor finds no mercy in his eyes. When a scoffer is punished, the simple becomes wise. When a wise man is instructed, he gains knowledge. The righteous observes the house of the wicked. The wicked are cast down to ruin. He who closes his ear to the cry of the poor will himself cry out and not be heard. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. Response. Guide me, Lord, in the path of your commands.
Guide me, Lord, in the path of your commands.
Guide me, Lord, in the path of your commands.
Guide me, Lord, in the path of your commands.
Blessed are those whose way is blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord. Response. Guide me, Lord, in the path of your commands. Make me grasp the way of your precepts, and I will ponder your wonders. Response.
Guide me, Lord, in the path of your commands.
I have chosen the way of faithfulness. Your decrees I have upheld. Response. Guide me, Lord, in the path of your commands. Grant me insight that I may keep your law and observe it wholeheartedly. Response. Guide me, Lord, in the path of your commands. Guide me in the path of your commands, for in them is my delight. Response.
Guide me, Lord, in the path of your commands.
I shall always keep your law forever and ever. Response.
Guide me, Lord, in the path of your commands.
Kindly arise for the gospel acclamation. Blessed are those who hear the word of God and keep it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Lord be with you.
And with
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. At that time, his mother and his brethren came to Jesus, but they could not reach him for the crowd. And he was told, "Your mother and your brethren are standing outside, desiring to see you." But he said to them, "My mother and my brethren are those who hear the word of God and do it." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This week we are reflecting from the book of Proverbs, giving us some principles of living a good life, what we need to avoid, what we need to do, and what we need to focus on in our lives as members of the family of God, as members belonging to different communities, as members doing different responsibilities. And in the gospel, we find, you know, a little bit complicated situation, but also surprising situation, if I can use it. That, you know, the parents and siblings, if you can use the word, relatives of Jesus, come out, you know, looking for him. I think it's also because Jesus had become very famous. But I think it's in Mark where the writer says, thinking like he had gone mad, they sought to get him out of the crowd. But Jesus' response is just clear. Who are my mother and my brethren? Those that hear the word and do it. Whereas in the first reading we are given principles, of a good life. The gospel is inviting us to hear, but also listen and be able to do just that. There is a part that I want to leave on. The getting of treasures by a lying tongue is a fleeing vapor and a snare of death. This invites us to be worthy and truthful and honest in our matters on earth. Not like, you know, the shrewd steward we had on Sunday, but to be open and honest in what God invites us really to do. What more can we look on for an example of a righteous person, honest person, faithful person, open person, than the example of our Mother Mary? A few days back, we celebrated Our Lady of Sorrows. But even in the sorrows themselves, in the afflictions, like on Sunday we had in the talk, sharing, there is hope. Hope for great consolation. There is hope for greater joy. There is hope for greater happiness. There's hope for greater freedom. Because you and I have heard. We have come to believe. And now we want to live. Let us ask God to bless us, that we might find ourselves experiencing a deeper sense of belonging to this family of Jesus, being brethren within our own families before the Lord for what he speaks to us. The family that prays together.
Stays together.
That my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, Almighty God, on the offerings of your people and our intentions, that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, grant we ourselves may become a sacrifice acceptable to you for the salvation of all the world. This is our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is right and just, our duty and our salvation always, and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, his death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy that for these gifts we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. at the time was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, O Lord, your church, spread throughout the world and bring out the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Philip, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, especially our sister Pendo, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, in our needs. Bless us. Heal my mom from her illness and bless her with good health, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may merit to be co-heirs with eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Father who art in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptations, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you say to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold, Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are you who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not told that you should enter tomorrow, but only say the word, and my soul shall be
healed. Bread and blood of Christ.
Thank you.
for Thomas Amisi and his family, for Sister Veronica Bisieri in her call, for Michael Mweni, for the soul of Pendo, for Holy Cross Women Ministries, Kenya, and for my mom. Dear Lord, nourished with the food of the valiant as we celebrate the blessed martyrs, we humbly ask you all that clinging faithfully to Christ, we may labor in the church for the salvation of all. This is our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless and protect you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.